up and start this match, get this one underway. So it is Gunwild vs Brothers, this is the third and final map for the Cybergamers Summer League. We're in the lower bracket, the one that will advance towards the lower bracket final, I believe. It would be either against Epix or Arcane. But Sneaker had been shut down early on. Domi does hear that grenade go past him. And now that their scope is down, they really don't know how many players on that B side, so they're going to be rotating towards the A bomb and see if they're going to be able to find a peak there. Should be slightly more easy than flushing out two players on that B side. But it's still a 4-4. We had a 1-for-1 trade in the early seconds, and looks like it's gonna go very, very slow. Kuhn, has he actually spotted Nemesis? Nemesis. He's actually fought back, and he was early on the A long tank, but yeah, decided to do just this position. He should be able. He should be landing his first shot. If he doesn't, then that could be a slight problem. Tacky now downing Dizzy, and that could be a bit of a cue for Gunwild to head towards the A side and just storm in. And we'll see what Nemesis is going to be able to do here. Just spotted a glimpse of one. Gonna again readjust his position, but does miss the first shot. So grenade does come in, but Nemesis far, far away. More grenades coming out, but Tacky sneaking his way forward. There was no cover from Brothers from mid. And Sneaky now goes down. It's Kaysen, your last man standing. With four more players to find as he picks up the MP44. But does actually manage to down Domi, and no idea how he saw that. But Kaysen picks himself up a frag of the Raphael. And now, gonna continue to make his way forward. Yeah, did just hear one up there, and he's gonna watch towards that wall. He was one gonna be able to peek him, but Tacky shuts him down. That is a great round by Tacky. He's actually got himself 4 kills, 1-2-0 in terms of scores. Speaking of with a sneaker, he was gonna be able to find a frag. Close, but still, no one crossed from Brothers, and that could be another round for Gunwild if they manage to plant that bomb. Domi now has been grenaded down, so he's out of the equation. And now Sneaky is going to make his way across, and there's no smoke yet. Quite concerning. Sneaky not going down just yet. Tacky being shut down by Yeti, and looks to be like a mop-up here from Brothers. Raphael does down Kaysen as he keeps on firing a spamming his M1 ground towards the BLE. Oh. Oh wow, Sneaker just comes around the corner and shuts down Raphael. It's Kuhn, last man standing, takes out two players. Now, one versus two. Looking to fake the plant. Yeti. Still lurking about. Gonna try and get himself closer. He's got himself to Tommy, you remember. There's another guy just jumping up and down, and Kuni's like, these little buggers, they just can't quite get rid of them. And again, just landing attack into Nemesis. 30 seconds left, Kuhn. You're gonna have to make some form of decision here. Gonna go for the plant. But Brothers are still keeping well away from Kuhn here, and I haven't got a nade, so it's gonna be pretty tough to flush out Kuhn. And Yeti's now being shut down. Oh, Nemesis takes out Kuhn. And that is now 1-1. Good effort there from the Dutchman.
Explosives defused. Axis win.
see if Sneaker is going to be having any more luck. Decides not to peek towards the A side and actually misses the shot. That player was just baiting him, and Techie is going to get graded down. And Yeti's been crossed. He's got himself a grenade as well, and Sneaker now being shut down. That is again your scope down and out for Gone Wild. Looking to be in a bit of trouble, but Kun does hear one. God, he is actually hearing two players. Sneaky is gonna get taken out though, and Kun is gonna check out a grenade. But that player is actually falling back and Kun not deciding to push him down just yet. Kun just hears all sorts of activity. Oh my god, does he just annihilate him with the MG42? Anomalous just jumps above, takes out Domi. That is Raphael now. Your last man alive. Makes his way forward, but the nade comes in from Dizzy. Axis takes him out. Win. 2-1. Brothers. Still 4 more players left up alive. Quite good stuff here from them. Ah, Sneaker opening things up nicely. Takes out Dizzy early on. Gonna be looking towards that second cross. As he did miss out that second shot. Well, that player is now being crossed, and that is Domi shut down. Two players from Brothers on A, and Memphis is not there. Raphael being grenaded down by Case, and just see him check out that grenade. Zeki though did just down Yeti, so it's a 2-for-2 trade, still 3-on-3 versus 3. And Kun out in the mid garden. Oh god. Oh wow, that is so lucky. Kun gonna get taken out by Nemalis. Kaysen drops Techie. It is now down to Sneaker. Has been a little bit quiet in this matchup. 1 versus 3. Can he do something nice here as he looks around that right corner? But Nemalis again just takes him out. 3-1. And the timer just seems to be about right every single time for Brothers in these skirmishes. Sneaker does down one, but again, it is Dizzy to reply onto Sneaker. A grenade comes out from Kun. There's in fact no one in SBLE and no one in the dark room either, so he's gonna make his way forward. He's actually managed to get himself in the dark room, but Domi's struggling. It's actually Raphael to take him out. Raphael goes down, and Yeti picks him up. The second one is a 2 versus 2. Both players from Brothers are on the B side. Tacky downs Dizzy. Is now a 1 versus 2 for Yeti. He's looking to find himself the frag of the Techie, but Techie actually revealing his position, drops down on the splash area in spawn. And Techie actually managing to shut down win. Yeti. There's now 3-2. Gone Wild, they really need to step up the game again in order to have a good half behind them. Oh, Sneaker lands it onto Dizzy, this time winning the scope battle. And looks like Brothers a bit reluctant now to cross. They're just kind of waiting for the smoke to come out, but it is no use against Sneaker. Shuts him down on the cross. And Kaysen dropping out a grenade. And there's actually a one from Brothers that did manage to get himself across, but Yeti now gonna get shut down by Kun. There's Thompson. Oh, Tommy taken out by Nemalis. Timing is just always worse. Okay, so a shut down by Kun. It is Nemal is your last man standing. And still Sneaker probably out there watching the cross. Nemal somehow does survive that engagement. Let's see.
Eliminated.
Well, and he just lands in the crosshairs of Techie. It is now 3-3. We have got ourselves a even Stevens. Let's pick it up with Sneaker again. Firing off a little bit too early, bit of a happy trigger finger. Now Brothers again managed to get himself one across. It is a Yeti out there. And couple of grenades coming out from Gunwell. I believe it was. Maybe it was actually Brothers grenading on that position. There's another player coming from Brothers. Towards the bomb side. Techie Gonna get taken out by the MG of Dizzy. Dizzy being taken out by Sneaker, and Dummy takes out Sneaky. Actually saving Coon's little ass. Dummy checking out a grenade towards the A tank, and looks like Gunwild do seem to be favoring this A side for the moment being. But still, with two players on his B side, leaving Nemelis like super alone in his A side, that is quite concerning. As the bomb will probably go down there. Sneaker did just spot a player crossing. It was Raphael going for a bit of a fake there. Dummy's going to be looking to support him. Gason does take out Sneaker, so there is still a chance for Butters to come back from this one. 3 versus 3. I believe it's Kuhn still out there in the mid garden. You should be able to take out one at least. Oh wow, yes, he just takes him out, just comes around the corner, and now it's Raphael and Dummy with it all to do. Raphael takes out Kaysen, and Nemesis finally finishes off Dummy, and it's Raphael, your last man standing. He's got himself the bomb planted, that's one thing. Oh, that bomb's just behind that wall, and he's gonna have to make his way forward, and the time is running out. Yes, he takes him out, and Gunwild somehow defused. Seems to be losing this round. Buddha's coming back with this one. 4-3. Picking up a round on that. Another round on the defensive side. Again with Sneaker. Not seen anyone across so far. Brothers, looks like they are going to be showing their aggression on A. As Dizzy takes out Dummy, it's looking pretty sour here for Gunwild. They need to hold that flank tactic with the one pop though, takes out Gason. But still, yeah, Brothers now slowing down that push. Taki and both Sneaker, I believe it is, making their way towards the side. Taki's gonna be lurking out there still. Raphael grenaded down, courtesy of Dizzy. Where's Taki? Still there. Techie does manage to take out Dizzy, and all Techie really needs to do now is just try and hold them off for a little while and just stay alive, be a nuisance. Oh, one bullet left. Not gonna happen though, Sneaky shuts him down. And that is Sneaker and Kuhn remaining, 2 versus 3. It's still very possible for Gunwild. That being said, Brothers have been doing quite well on their retake. Kuhn though does take out Yeti. Sneaker going for the no zoom, but Kuhn there in the backside shuts down Sneaky. It's Nemesis, your last man standing. Kuhn will take him out as well. 4-4. See Dizzy going for that same sort of peek again, and Butters again managed to get himself across. Who is it out on the B side? Coop, brilliant shot on that. That's going to be opening up that B side. Coop finds himself another one. Sneaker downs. Sneaky Kaysen comes back. It is a 2 versus 4. Or Brothers, the bomb's going to get planted on the B side. Kaysen tarting out. Land attack, again lands attack, not going to be able to get that frag, it's going to be Nemelis, your last man standing. Bit of a deja vu here, Plummeted Street again. Kuhn going to shut him down, that's hat-trick for Kuhn. 5-4, Gunwild casually taken in this round. There we go, there's Sneaker shutting down Dizzy. Is he going for that peek a lot? But Sneaker did spot a player across, and he's going to be calling it out to his teammates. That is Yeti just behind these wooden logs. And Gunwild seem to be readjusting their approach. Reacting to the cross of Yeti. I think he did spot one out in the back, and looks like it was an MLS. Decides to fall back, which is a good thing. You don't want to lose another player for Brothers. Case into the mid garden as he looks to reinforce it. Well, taking it very slowly here, Case, and thus hear a player out there, Downs Kuhn. And now it's a 3v3. A minute remaining. Oh, Case lands attack, but no frag. Ooh, Kaysen should be a little bit careful there. He decides to push out, takes out Rafael. Domino does take him out. It's a 2v2 now. There's some frags being exchanged. Sneaker has got himself two grenades. And they're trying to guns for a bit. Yeti unable to finish off Domi there, and Domino gonna push his way forward in the mid garden. But the time is running out. They need to get rid of Nemelis or just one player and get that bomb down. Nemelis being spotted, and again Nemelis just gets away with just a sliver of health left. Gonna go for the nosing, but Sneaker coming in the back, and oh my god, Nemelis is actually gonna get away with that frag onto Domi, but Sneaker does take him out. It's now 1v1. Yeti making his way forward. Will take out Sneaker fairly easily. No problems at all. 5-5. And Gunwell not really doing that well on their attacking side at the moment. Sneaker should have had that shot, son. Kuhn now being grenaded down. Sneaky picking himself up a double here. And it looks like to be a very good start up for Brothers. Sneaker gonna be throwing out a grenade. Kaysen being dropped out, getting a little bit too greedy. Still, Rafael. He's got himself a smoke as well, still good. Ooh, don't be grenading down Yeti, and that is going well now. Putting it back to 3v3. Has Tommy just been spotted, or is Nemelis shooting at someone entirely different? I'm not sure. Anyway, Domi's gonna take out Dizzy. That's a great play from Domi. And that is Sneaker pretty much alone on his B side. He does manage to take out Sneaker. Gonna keep on spraying out there. It's Rafael that he's gonna be able to have to contest with. But now Nemelis has been shut down by Domi, and that is pretty much a cue for Gone Wild to go towards that A side and get that bomb down. A Sneaky unaware of Rafael's position, as already Rafael has rotated towards the A side. Sneaky still kind of looking around where Rafael is. But he finally decides to make his way back to the German spawn. And surely Domi's going to be here, and Sneaky approaching that position. Sneaky does survive with some health left, but gonna make his way forward now. He's got himself some time to play with, but Domi's gonna make his way forward. He does see it's a fake, in fact, and it is. Sneaky Doom is a load of bullets. 65, going well. They need to win this last round in order to have some form of advantage into that German side. Looks like Domi's been shut down early on, and Kuhn gonna get shut down as well by Dizzy. So again, Brothers with two frags early on. However, Sneaker comes back. Oh wow, Case just sitting around the corner with his shotgun, but Sneaker does shut him down. It is still 2v3. And it's Yeti coming in the back. Oh, it's actually Sneaky, sorry. Looking at the wrong name there. Luckily for Sneaky, that nade didn't land onto his head. Fowl's looking to peek him down, but Sneaky again Just survives it. And looks like Gonewild just unable to get rid of Sneaky in the spawn house. Such a tedious player. Sneaky again spotting a player. But Nemalis does go down, and that's going to be opening up things for his A side. Raphael's going to be throwing out a smoke. Not the best of smokes, I guess, but does cover something, and Raphael's going to get shut down. It's Sneaker, your last man standing. 1v2, and only 15 seconds left on the clock. Does manage to get himself the bomb down, and looking to pick up the M1 Garand. Empty that gun. Ooh, Sneaker. But yeah, Sneaker does pick himself that frag. 66! Even Stevens going into the second half.
Explosives defused. Axis wins.
Sank for Gonewild. All the four players with 11 kills, only Raphael. Could have done better, but you know, sometimes these games. Just one of those games for him. finally, they have decided to ready up. Brutus versus Gunwale. First map was Dawnville, 13-8 for Brutus. 13-6 on 2Jane for Gunwale. We're on the final map, 66. Gunwale not having the best of halves on their attacking side, really. As Kaysen finds himself in first blood. It's Raphael in the dark room, missing a load of bullets. Domido does take out one, but it's not going to be enough. It's a 2 versus 4 already. As Brutus are going to be looking to go towards their bomb side. It's Tacky and Sneaker remaining. They did throw out a couple of grenades towards the B bomb side. It's not going to be enough to stop it, because Brutus are actually slowly approaching it. They're still kind of reluctant to plant that bomb, even though they took out like 3 players on the B bomb side. Tacky, there we go, goes down. It is Sneaker, your last man standing. They just spotted a player, but just nothing seems to be going right at the moment for Gunwale. Because it's now 7-6. Brutus doing well. Let's see, who's it? Dizzy. Dizzy is scoping for Brutus. Still sticking onto that scope. It just spot one. As Sneaky goes down to a grenade of Dummy. Looks like Gunwale gonna be looking to defend this bomb site. Kaysen being dropped by his teammate. And that is gonna be Gunwale probably picking up a round. They got 5 more players left up alive. And that is a deficit of 2 for Brutus. Raphael nearly goes down though. At least something went in his favor this time. And turtle mode again. Woohoo. Kun takes out Dizzy. There we go. Looks like Nemelis, your last man standing with Yeti. Well, not going to be able to do much if you have that kind of aim. Maybe just a bit of a caster's curse there. If it's Yeti, your last man standing. Does pick himself with one frag. Nearly gotta get himself the second one though, but still 4 more players left up alive. Can he do the 1v5? 44 to hand. But, this is Tommy just slowly crouching up to him as he will take him out. 77. Still, I think I'm gonna have to go for with Brutus with his one. Can only favor them since it's the more favorable side on this map. Oh wow, Dizzy just pumps out 3 players from Gunwale. Oh my god, with 1 grenade kill, takes out 3. But Domi and Kun do come back. That is just great play from Dizzy, but still Kun and Domi remaining. Domi nearly took out a player, but Kun goes down. That's going to be the B-bomb side open. Domi scrambling to make his way towards that B-bomb side. Another grenade comes out. As Domi is going to be approaching this bomb side. Dizzy though, that's committed back. There's now 8-7. And that grenade just made all the difference there. Let's see. Dizzy this time not going to be checking out the grenade just yet. Looking towards the cross. They just spot a glimpse of one. And, but is that going to be making their way towards B-bomb side fast? There wasn't really one across just yet. Smoke came out. Lots of grenades in that BLE. Making sure Gunwale were unable to go towards that bomb side. And looks like Brothers are going to be able to plant that bomb as well. And now it's a 5 versus 5 after plant. We haven't seen much of that at all. Gunwale, they are facing themselves a very tough situation here. They're going to have to show a lot of aggression to be able to open things up here. But Kun and Domi already been shut down. Sneaky with 2 frags. Yeti's going to take out Tacky. Sneaky, your last man standing. Just pick himself with 1 frag, but that was a gift of frag by Sneaky. But Dizzy will take him out. 97. But is now leading by 2 rounds. Dizzy is he unable to land a shot onto the grass. It is Saki to take out Sneaky. Domino does go down to Kaysen. Sorry, yeah, that's Nameless who gets shut down by Kun. Looks like Gunwale have got themselves a defense set up on that B-bomb side this time. It is still 3 versus 3 as I believe it was Kun going to grenade it down on towards the B-bomb. But still, I think it's Raphael in the dark room. Yep, there he is. Sneaker coming in the back, takes out Yeti. So, bit of a flanking attempt in from Gunwale. Dope Brothers with 2 plays. Gonna make their way forward, and we'll see what Raphael is gonna be able to do here with the shotgun. As he goes down, Raphael.
Eliminated.
Jackie does come in time to help Raphael out there. It's now 9-8. Let's see if Dizzy is going to be able to throw out another sexy grenade. Look at all these 3 players standing there. That could have just well happened again. Domi does find himself the first frag of the game, and Nemesis. Nemesis goes down as well. Domi shuts down Sneaky. Now, that's probably going to be an even Stevens in terms of score at any moment in time, but Dizzy does take out one. It is Dizzy and Yeti. Your last 2-4 brothers. And looks like Dizzy's going to... Oh man, just looks away. And Domi's just going to shut him down. That is a hat trick for Domi. It's now Yeti. Your last man standing.
Allies eliminated.
Axis. Just kind of wonder what he's thinking, picking with the Thompson towards Domi. But okay. So Dizzy, looking towards the cross, does take out one. So finally landing a shot on the cross, taking out Domi. And Sneaky shuts down Raphael through the smoke. And, this is a really nice approach from Brothers, taking out 2 players on the cross. And that should be pretty much a gifted round here for them, as it's now just Kun left off life. It's looking pretty grim for him. Out in the big garden. Oh, actually, can he take out one? No, he can't. Yet he's gonna take him out. 10-9. So let's pick it up with Dizzy once more. I want to follow that grenade so much. He's actually going to connect the grenade back onto Kun. Look at all these grenades coming in. Takedo does take out 2 players. So finally going wild, landing some grenades here and there. Raphael's gonna grenade one down as well, so 3 grenade frags are going well. And Dizzy though is gonna sneak his way forward. And he could do some damage here, but it's a bit of a one and done gun. Oh god. Does pull out the MP44, does take out Domi. What? How on earth did Raphael not kill him there? That is so weird. None of his shotgun shells landed. Yet he does take out Techie now. 2 more to find. There's Raphael's on the B-bomb side. Now, spot Sneaker as well. And I believe Raphael picked himself up a weapon as well. I mean, I can only assume he did. And Sneaker going all the way back towards the mid garden. Yeti. Wow, this is so tedious. But he's gonna plant that bomb. Sneaker will take him out, of course. 10-10. Win. Sanka. Dizzy is gonna be watching that cross yet again. Oh, Sneaker just shuts him now, midair. See if any of these gunwale grenades landing. Lots of grenades on that APC. And looks like it's Dummy. Was attempting to get himself across, but starts to fall back. It is a 5-on-4. Still Brothers, they got themselves on this B side. Grenade coming out. But the bomb has been planted in the meanwhile. And gunwale unable to stop that plant from happening. See who's in that. See Yeti in spawn. Dizzy's been shut down early on though. By a sneaker. And, well, you can hear that clock ticking down. And so far, no shots being fired at all. Well, they need to start moving in as Techie goes down to Sneaky. You will get a grenade down, but MLS shuts down Dummy, Yeti with the frag and the sneaker, and there's Raphael being cleaned up. Kuhn, where is he at? Over at the APC, but the bomb's ticking away. It's going to be 11-10.
Allies win.
Dizzy downs Dummy, and there's Kuhn with a grenade frag on the Yeti, finally. Some grenade frags again from Gunwale. The Brothers again making their way towards the B site. And Gunwale not landing those grenade frags anymore. As the ball will get planted, courtesy of Nemelis, but Sneaky does go down to Kuhn. And all Dizzy needs to do now is just try and stay alive. 3 versus 4. Dizzy does hear these players around and around, but does take out Kuhn. Does flick back to Dizzy here as he has been pushed from the side. It's Techie to take him down. Looks like Gunwale got themselves a man advantage, but still, they have to move in fast. Kaysen downs one. Namelis goes down to Techie, and it's a 11-11 now.
Explosives defused. Axis win.
Oh god. I feel an overtime coming. I feel it coming. Dizzy unable to take out a cross. Oh, okay. Takes out Dummy. Really explosive round coming out from the Brothers as they are looking to go quite aggressive here. And Sneaker does take out Nemelis, but Kaysen needs to come back. So far, we can see Gunwale unable to get themselves a return in. Brothers attempting to get the bomb plant down. Yeti takes out Sneaker. There's only two players left to fly. They're gonna just bomb it out towards the BL. Raphael takes himself with one frag, but it's not gonna be enough here, I feel, as he wow, does take out one more, and we'll go down to Yeti. 12-11. It's gonna be one match point for Butters to close this one out right now. Let's see, Dizzy's kills are gonna be crucial here if he's gonna be able to take out one. Oh man, Sneaker just shuts him down. And it has gone well, they're gonna be freely able to cross. Domido has been grenaded down by Kaysen. Ooh, Kaysen just survives there. It's now 4-4, and Brothers, they got themselves on his B bomb side, and Sneaky with the BER, the supreme gun. Oh wow, look at all these gone well players just running around like chicken. And they are going to get cleaned up. It's going to be down to Sneaker with 4 more to find. Can he go for the ace though? So all nothing for Sneaker here. That's another one in the back, and Sneaker still survives, still up alive and kicking. But the clock is running out. Sneaker needs to do something very special here. Eliminated. Not gonna happen. Nemelis will take it out. 13-11. But this will take it away and advance into the lower bracket even further.